two things on the edge, it's on the edge, yeah.
Just, I think we had the debate once before about council and then whose ward it was, because the people are gonna get killed no matter what, there are something's not done, so that's, so it's on the agenda.
But you can follow.
If you go around, they do go at tremendous speed, and I was told years ago that one thing that's all around is the pavement there, and it's spread off, hard to have to start the slow down to actually turn. But if it's a curve, it's maybe spread off that.
Yeah.
Suggestion is square off the pavement. Thanks. And last but not least, you might.
Yeah, thanks, Chair. I have sent a small list of from ourselves to all councils. Just a couple more of them, Seabank Road, this is road safety wellness. Seabank Road, Vaughan Road, Ormston Road, possible build outs. It's where the school crossing is on that road there. To assist pedestrians, and I say the school crossing patrol over Seabank Road to the nearby school, which is in the moment. Second one, possibly vehicle activated signs at various locations, possibly Rosen Street, Seabank Road. I know these crashing speeds signs are quite dear, but those areas, I'd say possibly Rosen Street and Seabank Road. And lastly, no, not lastly, sorry, on the next one, 20 mile per hour possibly speed, but it's not bumps. Email to the officers tomorrow at the Met, but an area roughly bounded by Seabank Road to the east from Tapers Drive in the south, all the way up to the right from Green Green. I know that's a big area, but there has been an awful lot of accidents, I'm sure. I'm sure that the officers know on there. And the other couple is St George's Mount. This is in terms of Brohaven, so the top part, Avon Street, from Albion Street up to Gorse Hill Road. That's Avon Street from Albion Street to Gorse Hill Road.
Did you say all?
And in terms of road maintenance, Molyneux Drive from Rosen Street. Monday drive from Rosen Street to the Barrett Estate. And the last one, please, is the Rosen Street roundabout at the bottom by the Travellers Pub. The area around the roundabout, it's all sinking. You know the roundabouts at the bottom of Rosen Street as you go down, out of the Travellers Pub, there's a roundabout with the palm tree on one side of it, all sinking. Just asking him.
If you were to grow it, you would have grown it.
No, it's quite nice.
Thank you for that, Mr. Pratt. I just want to ask a question of the officers. I want to ask the question, has there been any area that has a high level of accidents or near misses? That hasn't been covered by any of the suggestions that we've asked for.
Wallasey Constituency, there are a number of accidents right across the road network, primarily on main roads. And our central programmes for local safety schemes tend to pick up those priority schemes, but they have to all other constituency areas as well. There are a range of measures that have been suggested.
Somehow it would be missed. for one way or another. So it's nice that we've been more sensible.
As always. I'd just like to make two other points. There was one of the items that was in the lists presented, which you can take forward, was a suggestion to put a thing to work on with some signs on the white part of the traffic that the pedestrian flow, and that will provide a cost to members to enter the site to prioritise the funding flow and bring that more forward. It's one of those issues. And finally, just to mention around the big activated signs discussed in the papers for the last meeting on the 6th of August, that the taking the data out of those signs for a long period of time, we would get 12 months guarantee of that back with the ones out. The new signs that members have suggested this evening would be take a data card and download that information to a data card and share that operational data with the police working target. What seems to be fewer police officers and on our patch, more effectively, so the police bargain screens more effectively as to the times of their days of week that are likely to occur. There are some 20 big outdated signs in the constituency at present, and of those 20, it's around about £1,000 per sign.
So a decision will have to be made at the next meeting about the £20,000 to keep the traffic calm and signals that we've got already. Steve?
Question today, thanks Chair. On the new system, where now we can get these 24-hour reports to see the time of speed, are we going to be able to, still, I know you're passing the information, but can we still get the printout on the new system?
Yeah, it's an operational. I'm glad we get that. Via mobile phone, so you can sign on to the secure data server and then download that process and then advise the police where they might want to target some of their resources. I wouldn't want to be permission, not necessarily because it's operation. However, in the new way of doing it, instead of paying for mobile phones and the data cards, we would have basically an SD card type thing that you goes on camera.
So you say once that's set up, there's no ongoing cost?
Other than we would have to ask some of our inspectors and so on to take that data card out every how often we choose to do that and then process the data.
Chris?
Just for clarity, Chair, if you don't spend that 20 hours on the existing signs, if the activated signs don't stop working, you just don't get the data. But the signs still work.
Absolutely.
I think we should have maybe 24 hours in case anybody goes home and lies awake in the middle of the night thinking, there's a drop cave, I've forgotten. Or there should be some other traffic slowing down sign somewhere else. We're going to keep it open, I think, for 24 hours. So if anybody wants to email Caroline tomorrow with any other further suggestions, well, it will be closed sort of 5 o'clock tomorrow, so that nobody loses any sleep over an idea they may have. Is everybody happy with that?
Yeah.
There's no other business, I don't think. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Sorry, Andrew. There's been another suggestion that instead of having these particular meetings only in the town hall, that we maybe move around the constituency a little bit. There's two more to be had, one on the 17th of September and one on the 1st of October. So it was a thought that maybe we'll have one at the top end of the constituency, maybe in Lisa or somewhere that hasn't been confirmed yet, and the second one down somewhere at this end of the constituency. If everybody's in agreement, Caroline said she's quite happy to start looking for venues. So is everybody in agreement with that?
Agreed.
Okay, thank you very much. Thanks, Julie.
Yes.